think this is open?
I don't know. Let's try.
I was in an old church like this with my grandmother a few days ago in Budapest. Even though I reject most of the religious thing, I can't help but feeling for all those people that come here lost or in pain, guilt, looking for some kind of answers. It fascinates me how a single place can join so much pain and happiness for so many generations.
You're close with your grandmother.
Yeah. I think it's because I always have this strange feeling that I'm this very old woman laying down about to die. You know, that my life is just her memories or something.
It's so wild. I mean, I always think that I'm still this 13-year-old boy, you know, just doesn't really know how to be an adult, pretending to live my life, taking notes for when I'll, you know, really have to do it. You know, kind of like I'm in a dress rehearsal for a junior high play.
That's funny. Then up there in the Ferris wheel, it was like this very old woman kissing this very young boy, right?
Yeah. Do you know anything about the Quakers, Quaker religion?
No, not much, no. Mm-hmm.
Well, I went to this Quaker wedding once, and it was fantastic. What they do is the couple comes in and they kneel down in front of the whole congregation, and they just stare at each other. And nobody says a word unless they feel that God moves them to speak or say something. And then after an hour or so of just staring at each other, they're married.
It's beautiful. I like that.
This is a horrible story.
What?
It's not the appropriate place to tell it. But, well, I was driving around with this buddy of mine. He's a big atheist, you know, and we came to a stop next to this homeless guy. And my buddy takes that $100 bill. He leans out the window and he says, "Do you believe in God?" And the guy looks at my friend, he looks at the money. He says, "Yes, I do." My friend says, "Wrong answer." We drove away.
That's mean. Mm-hmm. No?
Yeah.